Hey, it's Planet Jazz on Gulf Islands Radio, or GIR. Yeah, my name is Rick Dennis, and we have Dave Gordon standing by, sort of manning the computer. We got some cool stuff to start off the show, right, Dave?
I think you're going to really like this. This is Joe Pass and Carol Kay.
Premium jazz guitar player, always one of the tastiest players on the block, and Carol Kane, who, in addition to on bass, who was one of the few female musicians that played on sessions back in the late 50s and early 60s.
Must have been quite strange for her, because she's a beautiful woman, too, and she was in with all these men, the members of the Wrecking Crew, and yeah, Carol Kane laid down so many important bass lines from songs that you probably know, like These Boots Are Made for Walking, and, you know, so many others. And that's a great album called Better Days.
And we should mention, while we're at it, that you can see a documentary on the Wrecking Crew on Netflix. And it's called The Wrecking Crew, and it features some quotes from Carol Kane talking about some of the groove she laid down for some of the big pop hits of the 60s, back in the days when most of the pop stars sang and they had a small group of dedicated musicians playing in the background.
Yeah, they were the deluxe session men in the country. Carol Kay was one of the greatest bass players, and still, you know, still is out there, and you can approach her. You can go on. Actually, I was told by a friend of mine that you can go on Facebook, and you can friend her, and you can talk about bass technique with her, and she's really open.
Really? I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Okay, well, next we have a couple of Hammond B3 players. And, of course, I was just telling you about a Jimmy Smith album I bought recently called Back at the Chicken Shack.
Mm-hmm.
I think he set the bar for all Hammond B3 players. And there aren't that many of them because it's a difficult instrument to play.
But, very complicated. And the feet are moving. Both hands are moving, you know. And this guy's grooving. This is Richard Groove Holmes doing On Green Dolphin Street.
brother Jack McDuff, and before that, Richard Groove Holmes, two masters of the Hammond B3. And, of course, it became a kind of a standard instrument in a lot of 1960s and 1970s rock recordings, but it started with jazz back in the 50s, I guess.
With guys like Jimmy Smith and Jimmy McGriff, Groove Holmes, and brother Jack McDuff. Brother Jack McDuff was also a playmate, an associate of Grant Green, who was one of the early groove meisters of the guitar.
That Hammond B3 has got a real throaty kind of...
wall of sound.
Wall of sound, yeah.
I love it.
Who do you have, what do you have next?
Well, next we have flute player Bobby Humphrey.
Bobby Humphrey. Oh, and that's B-O-B-B-I.
Right.
Yeah, I believe, yeah. Bobby Humphrey. She played in a lot of different sessions, didn't she, over the years?
Absolutely. And another one of those great session people who did a few of their own records, and this is one of them. And I think this is probably the most famous one, and it's called Harlem River Drive.
Harlem River Drive.
Chico Hamilton and...
Yeah, Chico Hamilton and a great tune called The Baron, which was later done by Hubert Laws. I really like that one. And, you know, Chico's real name was Forrest Storn. Forrest Storn Hamilton. He was born in 1921. Now, the guys that we started the show out today with, Groove Holmes and Brother Jack McDuff, well, they were both born in 1931, but Chico goes back even 10 years before that. And wow, he had a chance to work with guys like Count Basie and Jerry Mulligan and some of the truly greats. So I'm really happy that we can play, you know, music by artists that aren't right in the forefront of people's minds when they talk about jazz. These are like the workmen, the guys behind the scenes.
And from Chico, we go to Chick Corea, and we also have a band that I haven't heard before called the United Eight. But first of all, Chick Corea and Fickle Funk, and this is a pre-Return to Forever on Planet right. Jazz.
a fairly obscure group called the United Eight. It's just a bunch of Funkmeisters, 1972. That was really their only song of any note. And now we're going to play some more obscure, I would think, off-the-charts kind of jazz. And we're going to start out with James Reese and the Progression doing Jody's Freeze. But before that, we're going to tell you a little bit about another show that I do here on Gulf Islands Radio called Improfuge. And it's a mix of, well, I wouldn't call it a jazz show, and I wouldn't call it a rock show. It's a kind of in between jazz fusion, jazz rock, call it what you like. I think it's mostly instrumental, virtuoso kind of music.
And that, of course, is on Gulf Islands Radio from somewhere in the Salt Spring Island Woods, G-I-R for short. I'm Rick Dennis, and Dave Gordon is picking the music today. What do you have next, Dave?
James Reese and the Progression doing Jody's Freeze. We'll be right back.
Incorporated on the Prestige label, another one of those classic labels you don't hear from anymore. And that was a composition titled Bowleg. Before that, James Reese and the Progression. On Planet Jazz and Gulf Island Radio, on or GIR, as like we like to call it.
I like to call it that.
And let's say a thank you to Drew for the spaghetti.
Pretty good, huh?
and to Sean McIntyre for the great article on Gulf Island Radio in the Driftwood.
Yes, I have to thank Sean personally. They did a great job writing us up, and we've had nothing but interest since. So, you know, things are growing and looking up for us, and that's a very nice thing. And, it doesn't hurt to have a nice little rub up once in a while, does it?
And you should mention the fact, mention the online version of the Gulf Island Driftwood, because that's what part of the article is.
Well, a lot of people aren't going to get the newspaper, that's for sure. And if they want to check the article out that we're talking about, just go to Gulf Islands Driftwood, just Google that, and it's right on the front page. You can't miss it.
So who do we have next?
Well, we're going to wrap today's show up with a group called the Urban Ensemble, and I think this is a kind of a neat title. It's called Music for a Flowered Pig. Thanks, everybody.
We'll be right back.